and Nada Eddie Aruza, and a controversial former school principal speaking out about his removal. Eddie.
Phil, Troy LaRavier insists he was removed as principal of Blaine Elementary School because of his criticism of the Emanuel administration. CPS, however, claims it was due to LaRavier's mismanagement of his school and other activity the school system forbids. After weeks of keeping silent, LaRavier is once again blasting the mayor, whom he actively campaigned against last year, and the controversial ex-principal is not backing down. And joining us tonight to share his side of the story is former Blaine Elementary School principal Troy LaRavier. Thank you so much for coming in tonight.
Thanks for having me, Eddie.
So let's clarify. You have been removed from your post, but you have not been fired. So what is the process at this point?
Well, the hearings. The first hearing was yesterday. It's a board appointed hearing officer, and that officer makes a recommendation to Rahm Emanuel appointed CEO Forrest Claypool. So, you know, you can imagine where that's going to go. Then there's the ISBE hearing. There's an independent ISBE trained hearing officer, but then that officer makes his or her recommendation to the unelected Rahm Emanuel appointed school board. And so we can imagine where that's going to go. And then after that, you know, it's just a matter of considering my legal options, and everything's on the table.
Well, you don't sound very optimistic about the process because you believe everybody is on Mayor Emanuel's side. Do you think that you ultimately are going to get fired?
I think that ultimately whatever City Hall wants to happen is going to happen.
Well, you've been very outspoken, and your rhetoric, even today, we heard a little bit at the very beginning of the show, may not be helping your cause. You called the Emanuel administration corrupt, and you've said many other things. Should you have toned down your rhetoric to let the procedure go as it will?
So you said helping my cause. This has never been about me. This has been about the school system. This is about having a school system that equips children with the knowledge and skills and civic disposition that they need to make a better lives, to make better lives for themselves, better lives for their families, better lives for their communities. Helping them to get what they need to realize their full potential. That's my goal. And so any consideration about my own sort of personal benefit has never been a part of what I do. And so I speak out to push that agenda, the agenda of a school system that works for the children that are in it.
But and that'll never change. Can you do more as an insider, as a principal, rather than being an outsider if you're fired?
I mean, I think you can do a lot either way. I would certainly rather remain, you know, a principal. But I can't not advocate for students to remain a principal. And so I'm going to advocate for students no matter what.
Well, let me just ask you about what CPS is alleging and why they removed you. They said, first of all, that there have been severe deficiencies in your cash controls that you failed to address at the school. They also said that, among other things, you endorsed presidential candidate Bernie Sanders. And according to CPS's code of ethics, it prohibits principals from using their positions to endorse candidates. Can you address each of those, please?
Sure. So what they don't say is that when I came to Blaine, the internal accounts audit was a failure. It was unsatisfactory. When I took over the internal accounts, every year it's improved. We haven't gotten an unsatisfactory rating since I became principal. And so what they're talking about are paperwork violations. They haven't been specific. So something like one of these cash controls could be a teacher needing to fill out a field trip form and keeping a payee list for students who submit their money. It's something that simple is what they're talking about. What's clear here is that not a dime of Blaine money has ever gone to anyone that it wasn't supposed to go to. And, you know, unfortunately, we can't say the same about CPS under this administration.
Well, let me ask you about the political side of this, because you did endorse Bernie Sanders,
right?
Isn't that correct? And then last year you actively campaigned against the mayor. You sided with Chuy Garcia. So did you violate the code of ethics that the CPS says you're not allowed to do?
Absolutely not. Well, CPS can't tell a private individual what he can and cannot do in terms of endorsing a candidate or engaging in political activity. You cannot use your board-appointed title. I can't say, as a CPS principal, I support so-and-so. And that's never happened. With the Chuy campaign, there was a technicality. And so when I endorsed Chewy, one of the things they asked when I filmed a commercial was, what are we going to call you? And the title was Education Advisor. But whomever edited that particular video apparently didn't get the message, and so they put CPS Principal. But I have a record, a trail of asking the campaign whenever I would see something. So I saw the name Blaine on some material once, and I have emails showing that I contacted the campaign and said, please take that off, remove that. And so.
But again, could you have been clearer that you were removing yourself from your position and acting as a personal individual, a private individual?
And so I don't. The only thing you don't have that you have to do is not use your title. And so, and that makes me wonder what's going on with the Bernie Sanders campaign, because there is no technicality there. My title was not used in that at all. I didn't use it, and no member of the campaign made a mistake like the one that happened in that editing with the mayoral campaign. And so I have no idea what they're talking about with the Sanders campaign.
So this is what they're charging you with, but you're still saying that this was politically motivated, that somehow Rahm Emanuel was behind this, even though he says he doesn't micromanage these kinds of things, that he had nothing to do with it. You believe that it was political, is that correct?
I believe that it's retribution. I believe that it is, like I said, retribution. The term political, you know, the Civil Rights Bill was political. I mean, we throw that term political out as if it's just a catch-all for everything bad about our system. And so I'd rather use something a little bit more precise. And so I think there's certainly retribution. I think certainly the mayor's office had something to do with it. I don't know if the mayor is in control of every particular decision. The mayor's office is an institution that represents, you know, the wealthy interests that donate to the campaign. And so it's filled with people who work on behalf of those interests. And those interests were certainly behind this, whether the mayor himself had something to do with it or not. That office certainly did.
Well, you've been very vocal, as mm-hmm. I've just mentioned, for quite a while now. You've put yourself out there. You've been very critical. Has it had any impact?
Has it had any impact? People tell me it does.
In what way?
That the consciousness level of people in the city in terms of their awareness of the corruption and the ineptitude of CPS, their sense of why it's corrupt, their ability to give examples of why it's corrupt, has been uplifted as a result of a lot of the work that not just I, but activists and organizers and educators all over the city have been doing to help raise awareness about just how corrupt and incompetent this particular administration is.
Have you had any dealings with Forrest Claypool since he came on board as CEO?
Yeah. I actually invited him to my school for a panel discussion. He came, he participated, and he thanked me publicly in a room full of principals once. And so it's not, you know, what you see on TV and the sound bites isn't like what happens behind the scenes. When I did my research on charter schools and to show how the Office of Accountability had actually altered charter school test score data. I didn't publish that information immediately. I called the Office of Accountability to make sure my data was correct. I set up a meeting with that office. They gave me their reasons. Their reasons were unsatisfactory. They didn't add up. But I gave them the opportunity behind the scenes to address the evidence that I had found that they had engaged in the changing of test score data.
Well, then, do you think that Forrest Claypool will be fair in assessing your competency or your ability to return to your post when it reaches his office?
I don't think Forrest Claypool will have anything to do with that assessment. I think Forrest Claypool is going to do whatever he's instructed to do by the mayor's office.
So, what do you say to the parents and your students, a lot of whom supported you, a lot of whom maybe overwhelmingly support you? What do you say to them at this point and based on the accusations that CPS has brought?
So I go back to why I do what I do. We need a school system that works for everyone. We need a school system that gives every kid the knowledge and skills they need to make better lives for themselves. And so I say to the parents, I say to the students to work for that kind of system.
You are seeking to head the Chicago Principals and Administrators Association Union for Principals. And that's
not technically a union, but it is an association.
Well, the vote is a week from today, is that correct?
The vote's happening right now.
Or we'll know the results in about a week.
On May 19th, they're counting.
So if you are no longer part of this system, Can you still head this association?
Yes. The constitution of the organization says that someone who's a candidate has to be a member in good standing at the time of the convening of the nominating committee. That committee convened, they nominated me, they closed their business, so that's said and done. I mean, the current president isn't a part of CPS. She's a retired president.
If you win this post, do you think that'll give you a platform to carry on what you think that you need to do?
Well, this particular post isn't about a platform for me. You know, I've been effective at getting my own voice heard. That's not what this is for. This is about getting the voices of principals across CPS heard in a manner that is collective, where they come together, where, you know, and people who disagree with me, you know, I encourage that. It is that kind of, the problem is that nobody's voice is out there. We're not coming together to talk with one another, to disagree. When you disagree with me, my golden, you know, my gold standard is evidence. And so if we disagree, then what is the evidence you have to back your position? And this is the evidence I have. And we learn something from each other as a result of that.
How soon will a decision about your future, when is that coming?
I have no idea.
Troy LaRavier, thank you so much for being here tonight.
Thank you for having me, Eddie.
Chicago Tonight continues, so please stay with us.